Dean and I are very, very happy with the man that Emily chose to be her husband. We know that she'll always be taken care of. We know he's got her back, and we know she's got his. We know they have a relationship that will last forever. I love you guys.
Alexander.
Take you, Emily.
Take you, Emily.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise.
I promise.
To be true to you.
To be true to you.
In good times.
In good times.
And in bad.
And in bad.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Please stand. It is my great honor to introduce to you the newly married Mr. and Mrs. Emily and Alex Furman.
One thing I can tell you about Alex is this, though. I don't have a person in this world I won't call before him, because he is always there for you when you really need it. And I've needed it a few more times than I care to admit. And that's why I have no doubt that Alex is going to make a terrific husband and partner to him. Emily, I cannot imagine a better person than Alex to spend the rest of his life with. You are one of the most caring and kindest souls I ever met, and your ability to listen and help others is a true testament to who you are.
Emily and I have been going to school together ever since we were just little kids. I mean, like, since kindergarten, literally. And we were really good friends pretty much since the eighth grade. And then she coerced me and, like, pretty much twisted my arm into doing the High School Musical, because she was the lead role. And, I tried out and everything, and I ended up getting the lead role, too. And, you know, eventually we kind of had to admit that, you know, our parents were right, and that we kind of did have a little bit of a connection, and then it was all took off from there.
One thing I wish they would never change is obviously how much they love each other. He's gonna need some patience, and he's gonna have to be her rock. But I'm pretty certain he can do that after watching them together for the last few years. I think he's the most equipped for the job. So I'd say just be confident and be himself, because there's no one else you'd rather be with than Alex, and he's got this. I'm pretty confident he's going to do a great job.
Never go to bed mad or upset, and never let him sleep on the couch.
Deal.
I never let you sleep on the couch. Always sleep in the same bed.
Double deal. I love it.
Because Emily's a people person. She likes to have family around and people around, and I know, like, her grandmother and her grandfather really wanted to be there, so I tried to get everybody together for a dinner, and had her friend, one of her bridesmaids, bring her to the venue, and she walked in, all her friends and family were there, and that's where I popped the question, is at Lakeview actually where we're getting married?
Coolest girl I've ever met. By far, she is so wholeheartedly herself in everything she does, and she is so unapologetic about it. She doesn't think twice about being herself, and I just want you to know that you are married to the coolest girl that walks the face of this earth.
I know your spirit of perseverance will bring unity to your marriage, especially in difficult times. Adversity will help you both through inevitable challenges that stretch you. But the most important thing I will tell you is to keep God in the center of your marriage. May you be as happy as you are today, always. We love you very much.
Always be kind to each other and believe in each other.
Always care and love each other. And even take time to smell the roses.
Always respect each other and love each other and never go to bed at night angry at each other.
To always be happy, laugh every day, stay together as a couple but still be an individual and be happy the rest of your lives.
The hard times, and you'll see the waves and the storm through, and before you know it, it'll be calm again. We love you both.
Alex, you love Emily, and Emily, you respect Alex, and sometimes it can be as simple as that. And we wish you guys nothing but the best, and we love you, and we'll be praying for you.
Love you.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm honored today to be here with you guys. I can't think of two more great people. Your parents should be proud. From a teacher, you guys did a stellar job. Way you're going to do that is putting Christ in the center of what you do. Always remembering that you guys at the heart of it are best friends.
I would say my number one thing would be when he comes home from work, grab cheese and nacho cheese Doritos and have them in the microwave ready for him and a glass of Woodford, and he'll be the happiest man ever.
Mine would be just give him the dang back rub if he asks for it. Just do it. He loves them.
I see Emily and Alex being back here in Northeast with a couple of beautiful children living close by their parents, and hopefully planning a vacation with all of us real soon to go out and enjoy a good time, enjoy our loving friendship here.
Yeah, I think that Emily and Alex are also going to be back here. They'll probably have three kids, two girls and a boy.
Names.
Even though I think names,
yeah.
I don't know that
one. Alright, she's not that good.
But I think that they will have a very rustic-looking deacon and another little baby dog of some sort.
Well, in 10 more years,
maybe it's Alex's choice what type of dog this time.
Maybe. This is going to be Deacon 2, Deacon 3. This is going to be Deacon's friend.
Yeah.
It's Deacon Junior.
Yeah, Deacon Blues, Deacon Purples, Deacon Yellows.